my beautiful friends, and welcome back to another video. I hope you've been keeping very well. In today's video, I'm gonna be sharing with you everything that I eat in a week. The difference with this week though is that it was a really, really busy week for me, and I wasn't doing a whole lot of like food blogging and cooking. So it's really just a week of very, very simple, realistic vegan meals. Regardless, I really hope you enjoyed today's video. I hope you get some meal inspiration from it. And a reminder that if you do make anything from today's video or it inspires you to create anything at home, to tag me on Instagram so I can see your creations, because I would love to see them. Anyway, that's enough of my face. Let's get into the food. This is what I ate in a week. A busy week, really, as a vegan, and I hope you enjoy. So I started my week in the best way possible, which was with an iced cacao. If you're interested in my iced cacao recipe, by the way, it's on my website. I will link it down below. And it was a start to the week where I had not a lot of groceries left in the fridge or pantry, so I just had some rice cakes with vegan cream cheese, fresh tomato, some pepper, and then my iced cacao to go with it. When it came to lunchtime, I just decided to use up the last of the veggies and the beans that I had in the house for the week. So I roasted up some chickpeas, I boiled some sweet potatoes before putting some oil and spices on them, and then roasting them in the oven as well. I then served both of these in a bowl with some greens, as well as a spinach cashew cheese sauce thing that I'm working on a recipe for, some hemp seeds and some sprouts. And this was a really, really yummy and nourishing lunch to have on a Monday. I got a bit hungry in the afternoon, so I decided to just snack on some of these whole food bowls. And then I also had some of these chips, which are like, I swear, the best chips in existence. They're so good. And then for dinner, we had our friend Meg's around for dinner, and I just made a black bean chili. It's one of my favorite easy meals to make that is also very, very delicious. I served it with coconut yogurt, brown rice, cos lettuce, and some cucumber. Tuesday morning rolled around and Cara had bought some of the best bagels on the Gold Coast, and so I decided to have a bagel with some vegan butter and some Vegemite on it for breakfast, and oh my goodness, it was just so good. Then when it came to lunchtime, I used the leftover rice from Monday night's dinner to make a fried rice. I literally just put whatever veggies and beans I had left in the house in this. I think there was corn and peas and broccoli and chickpeas, I think. And then I put some sprouts on top. Sprouts make everything look good. We know this by this point. And then in the afternoon, I was feeling something sweet. So of course, when I feel something sweet, I typically make myself an iced cacao. How many times am I gonna say iced cacao in today's video? If someone wants to keep track, would love that. Then for dinner, I decided to use some of this pumpkin gnocchi. It's gluten-free pumpkin gnocchi. I've used it a couple of times before. I just got it from the supermarket and it's really, really yummy. So for this one, I simply put it into a pan and then I put some like pre-made tomato pasta sauce through it. This was a really, really simple dinner. I just put some nutritional yeast and some basil and stirred it through, and that was dinner. It must have been a warm one on Wednesday morning because I decided to make myself an acai bowl for breakfast. It's almost acai bowl season, so I'm pretty sure I'll be having them almost every day soon enough. I topped it with some of my homemade chocolate granola, as well as some almond butter, coconut yogurt, and frozen raspberries are the only fruit that I had in the house, so that's what I topped it with as well. Then for lunch, I had the rest of my pumpkin gnocchi from the night before, but this time I decided to make a homemade vegan pesto, again, a recipe that I am working on perfecting at the moment. I just stirred that through. I put some fresh baby cherry tomatoes, and yeah, this was a really, really delicious lunch. I love pesto so much. Then as a snack, I had some of these, my favorite bliss balls at the moment, and I got really lucky. I got an extra half of one. We love that. And then for dinner, I went to my friends Bonnie and Emily's house and they made a soba noodle salad. Oh my goodness, it is so good. We've had this a couple of weeks in a row now and I am obsessed with it. It's so fresh but also packed with flavor. Thursday morning started with the absolute need for a cheese and tomato toastie. So I decided to make a cheese and tomato toastie with vegan cheese, some tomato and vegan butter, and then I served this on an oat sourdough, which I love so much. Then I had this with an iced cacao. I got these little glasses so I can have a little iced cacao when I feel like one, and it was the perfect size. Then for lunch, I was actually going to a local vegan restaurant that I work and do the social media and photography for to shoot their new menu. So I also got to try their new menu, and that was my lunch for the day. I'll link them down below if you do come to the Gold Coast and want to check them out. I really recommend. They are an amazing vegan business. Then for dinner that night, I had a pretty late dinner, but I decided to trial my recipe that I'm working on for my ebook for a vegan lentil lasagna. This was also gluten-free as well, which was pretty iconic. So yeah, I just made a lentil mixture as well as a creamy gluten-free vegan cheesy sauce, which turned out so well. I'm really happy with how this recipe is progressing. I topped it with some nutritional yeast, and then I baked this in the oven for, I'd say, close to 50 minutes from memory. I really enjoyed this, and I decided to serve it with some salad. So it was just with some cos lettuce and tomato and cucumber, and this was a really filling end to my Thursday. So when Friday rolled around, I couldn't decide between avocado toast or cream cheese and tomato on toast, so I decided to have both. I also put hemp seeds and pepper on top, and this was a very simple and quick and delicious start to the day. I also had been really feeling like homemade potato wedges this week, so I decided to make some that I coated in nutritional yeast and almond meal and olive oil and salt to make them really nice and crispy. I baked these in the oven for almost an hour, and then I served it with a bed of cos lettuce. I also put some coconut yogurt on top to act as sort of like a sour cream. I would have put sweet chili sauce, but I had none, so I just put some tomato sauce on top, and this was a really iconic lunch. It was actually so delicious. Then that afternoon, I decided to make some homemade chocolate hazelnut milk. I have a recipe video for homemade milk, so I'll link it down below. And then of course I decided to have a glass of said chocolate hazelnut milk, because it's basically like an iced cacao but Nutella, you know. And then for dinner this night, I went out for dinner with my friends to a local Mexican restaurant. We had some cocktails as well as guacamole and corn chips. We also had this really delicious charred corn with, I don't know what sauce is on that, but it was really yum. And then I also had some crispy cauliflower tacos to go with it. Saturday morning was an errand running day, and Kara and I were out and about for hours. So whilst we were out, we decided to stop at a local cafe to get some brekkie. I got a choc chip muffin as well as pesto, tomato and vegan feta on toast, and an iced cacao. Of course. Then when we got home, I decided to have one of these fresh bagels that we got from the farmer's market with some vegan cream cheese, some spinach, tomato, cucumber, vegan cheese, avocado, and then yeah, that was my bagel. This was actually so good. It was one of my favorite meals of the whole entire week. And then for dinner that night, I was just feeling something super quick, so I just cooked up some broccoli, chickpeas, some rice noodles, as well as a homemade satay sauce. Super simple, easy dish to make, to be honest, and it's really nourishing but also really yummy. I have a recipe for a variation of this kind of noodle dish on my website, so I'll link that down below if you haven't seen it already. On Sunday morning, I decided to soak some oats in my homemade chocolate hazelnut milk that I had made earlier in the week. Something I love about making homemade flavored milks like this is the ability to just like pour it over oats and put it in the fridge and not have to add anything else. So I pulled it out after an hour or so and put it into another bowl, because I eat with my eyes as well. And then I topped it with some fresh strawberries as well as almond butter, as well as coconut yogurt, as well as hemp seeds. And this was a really nourishing and yummy, super simple breakfast. Lots of simple food in this video, so I hope it is inspiring you in some way. Then for lunch, I decided to, of course, make some crispy chickpeas with almond meal and nutritional yeast. And then in a bowl, I put some spinach, cherry tomatoes, and sprouts, topped it with some tahini dressing, which I ended up massaging through. Then I put some goji berries as well as all of my crispy chickpeas. And then I topped it with some hemp seeds. Again, a really simple and nourishing nourishing meal. And then for dinner on Sunday night, I was absolutely exhausted, so we got takeaway from a local Indian restaurant and it was so delicious. Alrighty, my beautiful friends, so that was everything that I ate in a week as a vegan. If you enjoyed today's video, I'm gonna leave a couple more videos on the screen that I think that you would really like. As always, thank you for being here, for supporting me and my YouTube channel. I appreciate it and you so much. Have a beautiful day and I will see you very soon for another video. Bye!